In a world covered in a strange purple biomass, where malicious aliens roam the planet's surface and underbelly, where resources are scarce and nearly impossible to obtain, who will save us? Who will save the Jaded?
Hi.
No, seriously, who will?
You guys know where I can get a coffee?
Oh, crap.
Hello, all you wonderful people. I am the Buddha Cat for Ready Player One Gaming. How are you guys doing today? And welcome to episode 2 of Blightfall. Blightfall. I don't know why I'm saying it so creepy. Because it's a really awesome, intense sci-fi mod pack. But really what it is, it's more of like an adventure map mixed with an RPG. Sprinkle up a little bit of some Minecraft magic. And wrap it all up in a neat little package and call it a mod pack available on Technic. And that's Blightfall. It is the newest, not so new, mod pack available on Technic. So I'm sitting here with the famous, awesome Captain Shiitake, who's just an NPC. But we're going to pretend that he's real. Hi, Captain Shiitake.
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, he's not much of a talker, so we'll just leave him alone. Sorry, I borrowed that chair. It says to not break any blocks, but I broke a block so I could bring the chair and sit next to my friend, Captain Shiitake.
I didn't even want you to sit next to me.
Oh, shush you. I know you really want me to sit next to you. No, he doesn't. Anyway, so let's get to it. Let's go. I'm going to meet you guys back up top on the surface, and I'll show you what I've been doing since last week's episode. Okay, hey guys, welcome up to the surface. This is where we kind of last left off, but I've been busy. Yeah, I've been busy. I'll show you what I've been up to. So, as you can see behind me, I started a little farm. Everything you see has been part of a quest, if that makes any sense. So, yeah, I started a little farm here, and I also started this right here. And there's some real, look at that thing behind me. Look at that. See it swaying in the back? Ooh. Anyway, sorry, easily distracted. I grew a couple trees. Well, that one sapling is not growing right there. I also found a way to print the badge. I clicked on the wrong spot and I got my badge. There it is. I built a drying rack and I hung it up right there. I also decorated my bed with some flowers and put two chests on either side. And that's basically it. Oh, I've also mined a little bit. So let me get back into first person here. So I started mining a little bit down here and really haven't found anything. I can't really go this way. I tried. And when I went over in this direction in here, first of all, it's so dark. And if you step on that purple biomass, it harms you. You start getting hurt. And there's probably a way around it. As you can see, there's tons of armor you'll see in a sec. It's like almost Terraria type of armor. Let's see if I can get to it. Where's all the armor? Here, look at this. Everything from copper, and then like it starts getting like eximite, promethium. I mean, look at all of this, dude. It's so intense. Tartarite. There's mithril. Quicksilver. Auroclase, I think. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing any of these correctly. Shadow iron. Volcanite? I don't know. Anyway, remember when there was an option here. It says tutorials, please. And there was another one that says, like, no tutorials and don't patronize me and blah, blah, blah. Well, I decided to do tutorials, please, and I'm glad I did. A, because it gave me more merit points, but also it kind of got me through some basic things that I'm going to need right off the bat. So I did this, and it made me build what you... I built everything here. So I have my part builder and the pattern chest. So I have all my patterns available to me. Of course, my Tinker's Construct crafting table. And the tool station to put the tool parts together. And then I started the farm. I've started because of this. So what do you have to say for me, Dr. Fairchild?
Hi, this is Budokat, and this is a disclaimer. This is an RPG, which means there will be lots of reading involved. I will do my best to keep it entertaining while still respecting the integrity of the story. Enjoy!
Because we're expecting this land would be fertile, our ready-to-eat food stores are limited. Corporal Driscoll can give you access to our emergency rations, but if we intend to establish a permanent presence here, we'll need to set up a stable food supply. See if you can get a farm going. We've got seeds here on the Jaded if you need them, but we're hoping the land is fertile enough in the nearby grass. Send us a loaf of fresh baked bread, and when you have one to spare, fresh food would lighten the morale of the whole crew and prove to the leadership of the Jaded that our settlement has hope.
Okay, so you think, oh, okay, well, he started growing wheat and barley. He must have bread, right? Oh, sure. I've got some bread. I'll show you. As you can see, it says primitive bread, though. So when I went to go complete the quest, oh, you see right here.
Please send us the following items by clicking manual submit. Note, we are not asking for primitive bread.
Well, you dumb person, you. So I found out that it needs to be bread, because this primitive bread says, hearty light meal, kind of rough. Try grinding it into flour, then baking it instead. So I have no idea how to do that, guys. So I had to get emergency nutrition bars through Corporal Driscoll, I believe, right? He's the supplier. Yeah. So I had to get some food from him because I was about to die. But anyway, so we need to do that. We need to figure out how to grind that up, and then we can open up these two quests. I unlocked this book. I haven't clicked on it yet. But basically what it does is it shows you where all the mining and resources are, but it will give you a minus one mission outlook, so I'm not going to do it just yet. I did build basic tools, which was a wooden pickaxe and a wooden mattock. I also built a flint pickaxe. Man, they do not last long, though. So now, our current quest, aside from the bread, is a copper pickaxe. So what do you got to say to us, Dr. Fairchild?
Getting past Mandate 2625B. You know, Executive Mandate 2625B only prohibits the construction of gold, iron, stone, wood, and diamond tools. Copper and most other unconventional metals can all be crafted into tools just as normal. Making tools the normal way means they can be enchanted on an enchanting table. It also makes them look cooler. Eventually, we'll also be able to melt metals down in the smeltery and make them Dr. Dio's way instead. That way uses less materials and makes the tool easier to upgrade and repair. It's up to you to determine which is better.
Well then, I guess we're going to have to go with this way. So please manual detect blah blah blah. So we have to make a copper pickaxe. Well, in order to make that, we're going to have to find freaking copper. So, guys, this is where I'm at. So through my little tiny mining expedition down here, the only thing that I've retrieved is what you see here. And these are all broken. They broke fast. I got some salt, flint shards, I got some flint, and I got some coal. So, yeah, we're going to be busy in this episode. Very, very, very busy. Not to bore you guys half to death, but as you know from last episode, there was lots of reading involved. This is an RPG. So, there's not just the instructor. There's also the supplier who gives us things when we need it, but there's also the geologist, the scout, the paranormalist, the colonist, and the xenobiologist. Each one does different things. So let's quickly read which ones are which, and let them introduce themselves to us. So, the geologist.
I'm Dr. Nagasawa, the geologist. Our scanners have detected quite a number of unusual minerals on your planet. Perhaps you can collect some from me.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Nagasawa. Next, we have the scout.
I'm John Rushton, Sergeant First Class. I'm in charge of geographic intelligence and scouting. If you have some time, there are a few places I'd like you to check out. Who knows? You might even find something useful there.
Wow. Sergeant John Rushton, you sound like a jerk. I will deal with you later. Now we have the paranormalist.
I'm Dr. Sprouse, quantum physicist by degree, but I do a little of everything. I try to explain what others consider unexplainable. There's so much science has yet to discover. For example, nobody will dispute the existence or efficacy of the enchantment table, but science has yet to explain it. I believe the mechanism behind the enchantment table is a strange energy I've measured, and I'm measuring the same strange energy all across the planet. I am interested in learning what science hasn't dared reveal. Perhaps we can learn together.
Dr. Sprouse, you're a little creepy sounding. Maybe I'll deal with you too a little bit later. Now we have the colonists.
Hi, I'm Miss Pulteney, elected leader of the colonists on board the Jaded. I have a vested interest in making sure this planet becomes a habitable place for the civilian population. Tell me, have you been cleaning the pollution or just playing errand boy for the military and scientists?
Wow, Miss Pulteney, it sounds like you've got quite a grudge. All right, and last but not least, we have the xenobiologists, and later we'll have these guys too. But for now, last, we have the xenobiologists.
Hello, I'm Dr. Bryson, the xenobiologist of this expedition. Could you perhaps collect some samples of the local fauna? It might help us understand what's going on in this world.
But thank you guys for introducing yourselves. But we're sticking with Dr. Fairchild, and I think we're going to try to find some copper. Okay, so I believe, yeah, see, this pickaxe is almost junked. I'm going to have to make another pickaxe. So, actually, I'm going to need my materials. I've got my materials. Here's my flint. I'll grab some stone, too. That's all broke. All right, we're good. All right, yeah. All right. Pop some flint in here. Got that. Okay. Nope, wrong place. We need a tool rod. Okay. And then we need a binding, yeah.
Okay. And then we're going to go over here and go to pickaxe. Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, buddy. All right, so let's hop on down here and start doing some light mining. Yeah, since we can't really go too far, I'm very confused on how to get rid of that purple biomass. Wait, can I harvest this? Yes, I can. What does this do? Is that just coal? Huh, interesting. Hopefully we can find some copper. That would be very nice. And there's like different types of stone. Like there's this, first of all, there's this red granite coal, which is part of the underground biomes constructs. This is not normal Minecraft or even biomes aplenty. What is that? Silver ore, nice. Oh, I can't harvest it though. Well, crap. What is that? Oh, wow, it's even more. I was hoping that there might be some other type of metal around here, but it doesn't look like it. But that's a good sign. That means that there are different types of metals down here. So, while we're doing some mining, and I know it's very boring, but it needs to be done. But I'm going to use this. Ah, crap, I forgot to make another shovel. Oh, poop. And I should have made another pickaxe, too, while I was up there. Actually, let's go do that. And while we go up there, I have something very quick to say to you all. Yes. So, lately I've been doing a lot of streams. And they've been really, really, really fun. I've met a lot of new people, a lot of new subscribers. And each one of you have put a smile on my face for different reasons. One of the subscribers that I'm thinking of in particular, one of the new ones, her name is Jess or Jessie, is J-E-S-S-E. So either one, maybe she'll tell me, But she was saying that she really likes the Blightfall series, which reminded me that, oh man, I really need to get this done. I forgot, I told her that it was going to be up very shortly, and of course I didn't get it done in time. It's been hard lately, guys. Ever since my grandmother passed away, some days are good and some days are not so good. So, I just wanted to quickly, what I'm getting at is I want to thank every one of you. I wish I could do it all individually, but I'm now at the last time I checked as I'm recording this, we are at 230 subscribers. Oh my God. I can't believe that. I mean, oh, it just makes me so happy. And I know it may not seem like a lot to some of you. And that's okay. It doesn't need to seem like a lot to some of you. But to me, it's a lot. And it means the world to me. And, especially some of these new people I've been meeting. It's just, I feel so fortunate to have just really nice subscribers. I don't need millions of subscribers right now, because the ones that I have are just so incredibly kind to me and so nice to me and so supportive. It's all I need at this moment. And hopefully one of these days I'll be able to do this professionally and make money off of it and maybe send my daughter to a good school and stuff. But at the moment, I am so content beyond content, I can't tell you. So anyway, not to get all sappy and mopey on you guys, but yeah, I did want to thank you guys for that. Also, can I use this on here? Yeah, I can. Cool. There was one more thing I wanted to say to you guys, and I can't remember what it was. I can't remember. I don't know. It'll come to me. Either way, that's basically what I wanted to say, was just a big fat thank you to every single one of you, to the new and the old subscribers. You all are so loyal and so supportive and so sweet and kind to me, especially during this time of need. Like I've said before in the past, I almost stopped doing this after my grandmother's passing, but it was because of you guys and how supportive you guys were that I keep doing this. You guys keep pushing me and inspiring me. You guys just, it never stops. I don't think it ever will stop, and I hope it never stops, because you guys keep pushing me to be better. But anyway, let's get back to the task at hand. And that is trying to find some copper. Good God, I don't know how we're going to find copper in this. This stuff right here, this comatite, I think is pronounced. It's really, really tough. It's hard to mine through. It breaks pickaxes very quickly. And, I don't know what to do. Oh, limestone, that's nice and soft. That's really soft. Maybe if I turn. Let's turn. Go down this way. Yeah, that's nice and soft. I'm just going to do some simple strip mining right now. Ooh, that broke. That done broke. Let's use the stone one for now. Oh, man. I know that mining, it can be kind of boring to watch. I'll try to make this entertaining, though. wait, what's this? What is that? Iron. I can probably get that with this. Wait, did I actually grab it? No. Yeah, no, dang it. What do we need? What kind of... we need a pickaxe. Soft non-metal, hard non-metal. Okay, so we need something that can mine. Dang it, and that's... Yeah, we're going to need that. All right, well, I mean, we're just going to keep going. We just keep going until we find something. And if we don't find anything, then we're just going to have to I don't know. Figure it out. Maybe move on to like a different quest. But I would think that this quest holds like priority over anything. I mean, don't you guys? That's what I would think. Huh. I don't know. So, yes, also, I remembered what I was going to tell you guys, by the way. So, if you guys, I would never push anybody to do this, but if you wanted to continue to help this channel, I mean, I have like a Patreon. Whoa. I have a Patreon and a, you know, like a PayPal set up where, you know, people can donate money and stuff. But that is not the only way to help support my channel, my cause, I guess you could say. Because my goal is to build a really happy, friendly gaming community full of, you know, friendship and everything. So, one way to do that is just to simply spread the word and let your friends be the judge. Say, hey guys, I subscribe to this channel and, I think he's, you know, I think he's pretty cool. Why don't you check him out? And if they don't like it, then okay, I'm not for everybody. That is for sure. But, you know, there is a chance that they may like me. So, you know, that is one way that you guys could continue to help. Otherwise, just keep doing what you're doing. Show up for the streams. Watch the videos. Comment. Be a part of the community. Continue to inspire me the way that you guys do. So, you know, that's basically it. That's pretty much all I wanted to say. My big fat thank you to all of you guys. A quick reminder of how much I love you guys. And then, on top of that, just a little message to let you guys know this is how else you could help. Am I actually mining that? No. But I am getting rid of it, I think. I don't know. But watch. Watch when I stand on it. See? It hurts me. It hurts me. Oh, man. I'm going to need more of this. Dang it. What is this? Huh. Interesting. What is that? Dacite Promethium ore. Ooh, and I can harvest it right now. Nice. Yeah, buddy. We're going to get some of this for show. For show, for show. You discovered Promethium. You unlocked a quest. Uh-oh, I think I broke my pickaxe. Broken. I gotta hurry before the stuff starts growing back. Oh, I can't harvest that now. Oh, what a bummer. So there's like no way to break this now? If it's broken? It just will keep smacking it over and over again? Or does it just take forever? Yeah, I don't think it works. What's over here? One torch left. Ooh, what is that? Ooh, I can get a shard from this. Sweet. We need shards, I think. When I was looking through the materials and things that we can craft, it seems like shards are pretty important in this mod pack. So, I'm going to grab these just in case. You never know. Oh my god! Guys, I came back up top, and there's a bunch of cows in here, and it freaked me out. Oh my god, that scared me so bad. Hello, Mr. Cow. Hello, other cow. Let's go to sleep. And in the morning, maybe we can build a fence and start a mob farm. Okay, so it is morning, and the cows are still here, and they didn't die mysteriously like that one chicken did at the end of episode 1. So maybe we could build some fences really quick and... Ooh! Are these matured yet? Oh, the barley is. Alright, let's get the barley really quick. And, Yeah, so we plant the seeds for sure. That's matured. Okay. This is matured. Matured. And none of the wheat is mature yet. It's unbelievable. Oh, the cotton is, though. That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's crazy. All right. Well, maybe that's why the cows appeared, because I grew wheat? I don't know. It's interesting. I wonder if I feed them barley, if they'll mate. Let's see. Ooh, yes, they will. Come here, cow. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Oh, quick, the moment's almost gone. What are you doing over here? Come on, what are you doing? Why are you hiding right here? Do you not like that other cow? Come on. Come here. I know it's not wheat. Oh, man. Yep, the moment's gone. You ruined it, other cow. You ruined it. God, I don't know what to do. How do I get rid of this primitive... How do I grind up primitive bread? You know what I mean? How would I make flour? Hold on. I'm going to type in flour. Here we go. Flour. Mortar and pestle. Okay. And to make that, we need stone and a stick. Okay, so we need to cook some stone. First of all, we need to make a furnace. Okay. And put the furnace over here. Boom. Put in some coal. Put in our stone, cobblestone to make smooth stone. Hey, buddy. Come over here. Hey, come here. Come here. Oh, look, 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 look. Oh, yes, I can lead them with this. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, there's about to be some love up in the air here. Be some love. Come here. Come here, cow. Come here. Hey. Yeah, there you go. That's right. Give me a cute little baby cow. Oh, hi. Hi. You're so cute. I love you. I'm going to keep you forever. Probably not, though. Okay, do we have our smooth stone yet? We sure do. Let's go in here. Oh, we need to make a... I don't have any sticks left. Really? What a bummer. There's got to be some sticks. Nope. Broken. And pretty much broken. Shards. Salt. I don't need this stuff. Not right now, at least. Okay. Anyway, let's go make some sticks really quick, and then we can make our mortar. Okay, we go like this. Stone. Yeah. So we go like this and put some barley in here. Yeah. Heck yeah. Sweet. So what if I go like this? No? How do I make bread then? Do I just cook the flour? Bread. Pumpkin bread. No, not this. Bread. Barley. No. See, that makes primitive bread, you guys. I'm having a hard time here. Maybe I just put the flour in. Yes, it's working. Yes, we did it. We made regular bread. We can complete this quest. Sweet. And now we have cooking for blockheads and then dietary variety. Let's see what this is.
If you ever want to know what foods you can make, you can build this special table and place it next to your food chest. Right-clicking on the table will show you all the foods you can make with the ingredients in the adjacent chest. That should help you see at a glance what your food situation is.
All right, so how do I make a cooking table? Let's see. C-O-O Kai? Kai Anjai! Oh my god, I can't talk. Cooking oven and a cooking table. Very cool. Cooking for blockheads, number one. So we need a cooking for blockheads. Weighted pressure plate and a craft. Well, how do you make the book? How do you make this? Oh, you just burn the book. Right? You smelt it? You smelt a regular book. I know where a book is. I know where a book is. Okay, hi guys. We are aboard the Jaded again, and I'm going to show you where a book is. Bum-ba-da-bum! There's one hidden here in the bibliocraft table, so yeah, all we have to do is right-click. So can I actually just go back? Biodome Alpha, cool. And here we are, we're back. Where are my cows? One cow, two cow, and a baby cow. Hello, baby cow! All right, so let's go here, and I'm going to try this. I don't know if it's actually going to work. I think it's 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 going to. Yes! Oh my god, guys, we did it. All right, so now we just need to make a weighted pressure plate, right? Yeah. Oh. I say yeah way too quickly. Now we need iron ingots. Crap. How are we going to make iron ingots when we can't mine the iron? I know where iron is. We just can't get it. We were too excited too soon. That is a sad thing. Sadness all around. But anyway, let's see what our other quest was. There was the dietary variety.
Are you getting sick of bread? It's okay. There are plenty of other ways to prepare your wheat, especially if you have salt, a few cooking implements, and a couple other ingredients. Try making these foods. They should be far more palatable than your eighth loaf of bread. Better yet, filling foods make you well-fed for longer, increasing the rate at which you regenerate health.
So we need to make toast, breaded pork chop, fish sticks, and apple pie. I'm assuming we're gonna need the cooking table first. Whatever. You know, just out of spite, I'm gonna eat this primitive bread. Well, what we could try doing is smelting this right here, and maybe, just maybe, this will work. Let's see if this will make an ingot. And it sure does. Promethium ingot. Can we make a promethium pickaxe the old-fashioned way? Promethium pickaxe. Yes, we can. And with a promethium pickaxe... It doesn't give me the stats on it, but that's okay. All right. We have enough now to make our pickaxe. Let's try it anyway. If this doesn't get the iron, that's all right. That's all right. Ooh, yeah, time to mine, getting an upgrade. Love seeing those achievements. But first,
I'm getting tired, so night-night.
Good morning, let's go try to get that iron. Wait, before we do that, let's make the rest of these torches. All right, I'm not gonna make a lot. In fact, I can't make a lot anyway. So, but 28 should totally suffice. All right, back down to our very strange strip mine. And maybe this will work. I don't know. Cool, we got our silver though. And look, we unlocked more in our materials book. Hopefully we can get this iron. Hopefully that's a good sign. Where was that iron? Down here? Yes, we can. Oh, that's so exciting. Yay, that means we can make our cooking table. Now I feel like this episode wasn't a complete waste of time. I was a little concerned at first. All right, cool, guys. We're back up at the surface. Now we can smelt our iron. And we can make our cooking table. Oh, we're gonna need more iron, eh? Uh-oh. Ruh-roh. Maybe I can at least do some charcoal. Oh, look at that. Wow. That coal actually smelted all five. So, in the meantime, we're just going to make some of this charcoal. Cool. All right. Well, then let's make our weighted pressure plate. Like so. Go like that. All right. So, we need to sandwich them. Oh, really quick. We need a crafting table. Okay. And then the pressure plate on top. And then we need the book, which I put in here. Right? Yep. Okay. And we're going to go back here. And no, we did it wrong, apparently. What did I do wrong? Cooking table. Oh, yeah, we need the blockheads. Okay. All right, so first of all, yeah, we just need to do this. Now, we need to make yet another crafting table. Wow, that's a lot of wood. Okay, I gotta do it. I'm gonna grab these. Cool, perfect. You know what? No, I'll leave the two charcoal in there. All right, so yet another crafting table. Like this. Yay, we have our cooking table. Aren't you guys excited? Probably not. Either way, I'm excited! Yay! We just need to put a chest over there full of food. And let's see if this actually works. Where's the salt? There it is. Look at that! Cool. So, yeah, I guess that's all we can make at the moment is flour and primitive bread. But whatever. So yeah, anyway, that is going to be it for our episode. We did... Oh, no, wait. We gotta complete our quest. We have to complete our quest. Sweet. Anyway, so yeah, we completed quite a few quests and we got some stuff done and we learned some things too. And we got some cows and a baby cow. Yay! Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching yet another episode of Ready Player One Gaming and hanging out with me, the Buddha Cat. I would really, really, really appreciate it if you hit that like button because it helps me and it also shows me that it is worth putting the effort to put this stuff up for your guys' enjoyment. Also, if you're new to the channel and you have no idea who I am or what this channel is about, let me be the first to introduce myself. Hello, hi, my name is Buddha Cat, and you are watching the channel Ready Player One Gaming. I would feel so honored and so privileged if you checked out the rest of my content, and maybe, just maybe, if you like it, you will subscribe and you will be officially supporting one of the coolest channels on YouTube, and it has been scientifically proven by Bill Nye himself. But not really, so please don't sue me, Bill Nye. Until next time, guys, I am the Buddha Cat for Ready Player One Gaming, and I will see you all later. Goodbye!